Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Speedster Plays Fire Emblem Fates Birthright. In the last episode, we did the first paralogue where we went off to a little small village being attacked by the Faceless, only to find a lone survivor in the form of a girl named Mozu. Is it, Mozu? Yes, Mozu. Double checking, because I can be dumb. Okay, so yes, we saved Mozu and she joined the team. So she's a villager who's going to be like Donald was in Awakening, so hopefully she'll end up being doing pretty good. So, and of course, I've been doing some leveling off screen. Got stuff. I opened the lottery shop, so I didn't get anything in the lottery shop there. And where did I also go? I also went to the mess hall, which is supposed to be where I can make food to temporarily boost the stats of different party members, but nothing much came out of that. Been going to the private quarters, been leveling up Lilith in here, but for the most part, not much has been happening. So as a result of the leveling, we do have a support conversation between Silas and Mozu, because I basically had Mozu paired up with Silas, so like Mozu could get Silas's stat buff, so then she could be strong enough to you know, take out enemies in the challenges. But you know, we might as well go and see what their conversation is.
Silas, do you think I should ditch and go home?
I don't understand. Why would you?
Oh, you know, I'm not too strong, and I worry about holding everyone back. I practiced till I'm blue in the face, and it's just not working. Everyone else is a natural. They get better by leaps and bounds. Not me, though. I'm not fit for anything but working the fields. I'm thinking I should find myself the nearest village and sign on as a farmhand.
I didn't know you felt this way.
Sorry for taking your ear off, Silas. It was really good of you to listen.
No worries. In fact, I know just what we should do.
Huh? We?
I'm going to coach you, and there's no time like the present to start.
Huh? But I can't...
You can't do anything you don't try to. Now then, let's head to the practice field.
I don't know about this.
Ah, see, that's being supportive. Supportive thing. He's being a friend. He's being supportive. That's the important thing. So, I guess since I, like, put off stuff because I was off at the, I was off doing the parallel last episode, I guess we'll actually go off and do the next chapter in this one. So chapter 8, having defended Fort Jinya against Norian invaders, Speed recruits a long lost friend. Now with Ryoma and Takumi in danger, the party sets out towards Izumo. Yep, okay, let's head straight in to chapter 8, Fierce Winds. Okay, let's see what happens here. Okay, the Eternal Stairway. Ooh, sounds pretty cool right off the bat. We'll see how this goes. Am I a little talker down?
God, these stairs seem to go on forever.
We can do this.
Indeed, but what did you expect? This is the Eternal Stairway.
Not to worry, we've almost reached the halfway point.
What?
Right, suppose there is no 5-minute stairway we could have taken instead.
Please,
Lord Speed, please be silent for a moment.
Oh.
Yeah, that fell a bit flat. Sorry.
Hmm.
No, that's not it. I'm sensing an unusual presence. I think we're being followed. How is that possible? I haven't seen any signs of life.
Listen.
Attention, whoever you are. Show yourself now if you wish to avoid conflict.
Oh, it's Faceless. I think I managed to sneak up.
No!
Faceless, where did they come from?
Hmm.
How strange. I expected humans. The Faceless usually aren't this stealthy. In any case, we have no time to spare. Let's take them out.
Okay.
Azure, can you please guard Sakura while we deal with this?
Yes, of course.
Big brother!
Be careful, Speed.
We've got
Are you ready, Kaze? Let's do this.
Yeah.
You can count on me. Yeah.
Okay, we're fighting.
Stand aside or be destroyed.
Okay. Alright.
Alright, just a few more standing. I don't like that ellipsis. It's a bad sign. Yep.
Wait a minute. What's this? Everyone hold! Something isn't right.
What's that?
What's the matter, Speed?
No.
These aren't faceless. They're people! Cause, what have we done?
Unbelievable.
I'm afraid you're right. I recognize their clothing. These people are from the Wind Tribe.
What was that?
I don't understand. A moment ago, this person right here was a faceless monster. Who's there? Show yourself at once.
That voice sounds a little bit familiar. Yes. I thought it was familiar.
Hello.
Good day, Princeling. Did you enjoy my magic trick?
Iago, what have you done?
Oh.
I didn't know a thing. You're the ones who struck down these poor villagers.
Why? What could you possibly have to gain?
Let me explain.
Don't you see? This is just the beginning. Now that you're with the Hoshidans, anything is fair game. Oh, your ignorance does tickle me.
And he's gone. This puts us in an unfortunate position, to say the least. The route ahead takes us through Wind Tribe territory, and we're going to have a hard time explaining what just happened.
Big Brother!
Who was that maniac anyway? Do you know him, Speed?
Yeah.
Yes, his name is Iago, King Garen's right-hand man. I didn't know he was capable of this sort of thing. He probably made us appear to be faceless to those poor villagers.
I see.
Well, he did do us one favor. He revealed himself to us as an enemy. I'm sure we'll have to go through him to get to King Garen.
Yes, I would expect so.
Okay, that's not a good start. It's a good start. Not a good start. We've just kind of made ourselves look horrible in the process. Wind Tribe Village. Yeah, this ain't gonna end well, probably.
We've arrived. This is the Wind Tribe Village we must pass through. Lord Speed, are you certain you want to approach this village directly?
Yes.
Yes. Trying to sneak around will only make us seem more suspicious. Surely they'll understand that we mean them no harm. I'm not as optimistic, but I will trust your judgment. It looks as though the decision has been made for us.
Okay, yep, they're coming to attack us.
It's them!
Here they are, the savages who attacked our people! Prepare to die. Please wait, we can explain. It is true that we fought with some of your people, but we were deceived by an enemy from Nor.
What did you say?
Please, how stupid do you think we are? This is going well. Right, any ideas?
Excuse me, can I have everyone's attention?
Sakura,
be careful.
Please forgive us.
Okay, she's done it.
We are so sorry to have hurt your people, but you must understand that they appeared before us as faceless.
Lady Sakura, you're with these brigands? Yeah, what's going on here?
My apologies.
Please, you must believe us.
Lady Azura was with them too. Maybe they are telling the truth. Hold that thought. Have you considered that this might be a trap? Either way, we can't make this decision ourselves. Let's see what Chief Fuga has to say.
Yes.
Very well. We'll be happy to speak with your Chief Fuga. Speak? Someone don't think that's what the Chief will have in mind. I see.
Wait.
Be careful, Speed. I believe your strategy is sage, but we are putting ourselves in a highly vulnerable position.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm well aware of that. What choice do we have?
Okay. And, okay, let's see what we got here. There's places in the plains. Okay, so we've got Samurai. Oh! So we got Azama, Setsuna, and Hinoka. Well, then we got Hinoka. It's a monk. Okay, so we got a healer and an archer, and we got Hinoka. That's, of course, good. Okay, so what do we got around here? So they've got a healer of their own. Okay. Ooh, this guy was a little tough. This might not end well. Okay, so I think I'm gonna drop Mozu out, and I'm gonna keep Saizo. I'm gonna put Saizo in, so we can have them all in. So, okay, so what people have said to me is that maybe I shouldn't just, you know, always have pair-ups, because I'm just used to having pair-ups. So I guess for this chapter, I'm going to try having absolutely no pair-ups. Everything is just going to be how it is. I have a feeling that that might work out well for us. We'll just, I just want to have a try and see how that goes, because people are saying that it makes more sense to just do it this way, but I guess I will just have to wait and see how this goes. Okay, so, just trying to figure out how I want to do this, because I would want to get here and turn that into plane. So Tsubaki can move unhindered. Silas is restricted. Okay, so Orochi can actually move perfectly fine, and so can Sakura. So I'll keep them in front, and so can Felicia. Okay, so I'll just keep them like this. Okay, that should do. Let's fight.
What's going on here? I thought the Wind Tribe was neutral.
So it goes.
Oh-ho, the human mind is weak and malleable. Things change.
Ahem.
Oops.
Oh?
Setsuna, have you shrunk about, a foot or so in the last minute?
Help?
No, I'm actually sinking in some quicksand.
Hmm.
Quicksand of this latitude? How fascinating.
No.
Am I going to die now?
Yes.
Physically, yes. Probably. But your spirit will live on in our memories.
Huh?
Azama, why aren't you doing anything to help her? And Setsuna, why are you so calm? Is this some sort of joke? Yeah, suppose I'll have to save you.
Thanks.
Ah, thank you, m'lady.
My, Lady Hinoka, the hero.
Azama, we are currently under attack. Can you try to be serious for 2 seconds?
Yes.
Of course, m'lady. Although I'm currently without any battle implements, so... I'm afraid I'm at the mercy of your protection.
Me too.
I think I'm stuck in the quicksand again. God, I knew I can rely on the two of you. But this is worse than I imagined. Just try and hold it together long enough for us to see this through, alright? Maybe Ryoma and Takumi can help me babysit once we finally catch up to them.
Okay. See this goes. Okay, so I'm not in control of them, so... Do I have to get up to them and talk to them? Okay, so... Majora can reach me there. Thinking to go... here. Or would that not work? Let's see how many spaces he can move. So, I can move 2 spaces. So, I'd want to move in a way so I could get to here next turn. So... But then I stood here. Right. We could go like this. And sure, I might take a little bit of damage. And this wouldn't actually take him out. But, is that what I want to do? I guess I could go see how Orochi would do. Okay, maybe I'll go with Orochi here just to get a bit of chip damage off. She go fine. Let's use that. Bit of chip damage, and she gets herself a level up. But yeah, I haven't really used Orochi before, so she's kind of interesting. But she's just basically a basic spellcaster that I'm used to. Okay, so together this would be able to kill. So yep, we'll go for this. All right, let's see how this goes. All right, excellent.
I'm impressed.
Good start. Okay, so this should be able to turn it into planes, and then we'll be able to move.
Remain calm.
Be able to move properly. Okay, Azura can reach me and give me another turn, so then I can go and activate the Dragon Vein and create the speed planes. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna try and not use any pair-ups here, so this can hopefully work out fine. Okay, let's make that into planes. Okay, so now let's just move everyone up and around. Just keep everyone moving. Now... Okay, nobody took any damage, that's good. Now, I guess Sakura can head over here, because maybe Sakura can talk to them as well. Now, Saizo, Felicia, because Felicia can move, like, her full distance. Okay, now Tsubaki over here, because he doesn't have restricted movement. Okay, their turn. Okay, they're moving around, because they're restricted by the desert as well. Okay. It's fine, can I reach, can I talk to... Hinoka? I was assuming I could talk to Hinoka and this would work. Can Sakura talk to her? Nope. I'm gonna assume that I have to talk. So I'm going to go like this. And Azama, why the hell would you move in range of this guy? Why my? I mean, like, I guess you have a decent bit of defense, but it still seems pretty dumb to me, so... Okay, this is a red weapon, so I guess theoretically I could go up here, and guess I could have Saizo go up here to assist, because that could work fine there. Azura, give me another turn, so maybe I can talk to Hinoka, and maybe recruit them to the team, because that might be what's required here. I'm going to assume that. Yep. All right.
Big sister!
Hinoka, what are you doing here? Huh? I can ask you the same question, Speed.
Well,
a lot has happened. I thought you were in the capital.
Uh-huh.
Yes, I was. I decided to try and catch up to Ryoma and Takumi on their way to Izumo. It's good that we met up, but I have some bad news. Ryoma and Takumi are missing. We're trying to track them down.
What?
Missing? Oh, gods. They're not the sort of men that simply go missing. What has happened to them, Speed?
We don't know. And we've run into a few problems of our own along the way.
Yes, I can see that. I thought the Wind Tribe was neutral. Why are we fighting?
It's
a
long story. Believe that we'll be able to explain ourselves to the chief.
Will you join us? We can certainly use a little help.
Of course. Although, a little help is about all we'll get from these two.
Huh?
What do you mean by that? Never mind. I'm just happy to have you all on our side. Let's do this.
Okay. This works out well. And I guess I have control of Hinoka now. He's not much use, so this is a... Green, okay, Azama's level 7, and Suna's only level 3, so she's not actually that tough right now, so... Hey, how should this go now? I guess Hinoka can also activate the Dragon Vein as well if I needed to. But I think I'm gonna leave it... I guess I'm gonna move Azama out of the way. And, start moving everyone around. Because it seems kind of important to keep things moving. Hopefully we'll be able to sort things out soon. I'm gonna keep Kaze near me because people are saying that I should A, support him for some reason, but I'm assuming it's important, so I'm gonna keep that option open. Okay, let's go for this. Now, everyone move around. I guess if we're near each other, we can support one another, so go for this. It's gonna happen. Okay, at least it's not gonna block. You get us. At least you get two hits there. Okay. Worked out fine. Now they're moving around. Alright, so now. And I guess, how should this go now? How would Hana go in this situation? Would not take out. Would not take out in the slightest. I guess, how would Silas go in this situation? Okay, just trying to think this through. I'm still like, getting my head around the new mechanics. Well, different mechanics, so... Okay, Azama can't really do much there. Okay, so... I guess it would make sense to try and get... Where's Setsuna? What range is... And oh, she's actually got some decent strength. Oh, it's just on this guy because like that is a decent bit. But then I guess he also does have his stats lowered thanks to the shuriken. So you know what? Setsuna get some experience. Just please don't make me regret this decision.
Next.
Okay, just get a little bit of experience. That'll help. Okay, just don't make me regret this decision. Okay, so... I'm gonna think about going here. Give him... Equip the steel sword. And wait there. And then Hana. And come up, and... Okay. That isn't gonna go the way I planned, but you know what? We roll with the punches.
I have faith in you.
Okay.
To the rest of them.
Come on, Hana, that's 24% chance. Seriously? Hana frustrates me. She seriously frustrates me. After that... Maybe just, like, after that first chapter, I've just gotten, like, a bad vibe for her, but she's just like, can you seriously not, like, land at, like, 24% chance?
We can do this together.
Come on, Hana.
This one's for you.
Okay.
So fast.
All right. At least they both got level up now. It's good. Alright. Okay, she's a little bit stronger, but... The question is, does this, like, increase her evasiveness?
Yes.
Because that's all I really care about right now. I want her to be more evasive. Okay, so... Okay. Who should go and, activate the Dragon Vein, so... Hinoka can go and... activate the Dragon Vein. Wait, is that a good idea to do this turn? I'm not sure if that's the best thing to do this turn, because this would give them, it would give them the ability to move across as if it was planes. So maybe I'll hold off on that for a turn. Okay, so this is green, so I'd probably be best going in with a red to deal with him. So how would this theoretically go? Not as well as I might want, so... Okay, so if we get another ranged unit in, this could work out decently well. I could send in Felicia as well. Okay, so where would Orochi be standing? There. So Felicia. Move around to there as well. and have Orochi go up here, and this wouldn't actually do anything. Okay, good. Let's just go for this. At the very least, I might lower stats. Okay. Okay, that didn't do much. At least it lowered. At the very least, you got the stat. You got the stat lowering. So. Okay, he couldn't reach either. So. Doesn't really help either. Guess I really want Tsubaki can fly in and finish this off. Yeah, Tsubaki can just fly in and finish this off. Okay. Okay. There you go. Yeah, okay, this kind of like, they kind of standing next to each other kind of helps. Okay, there's benefits to it. I just wasn't sure exactly what all the benefits would be in that case. Yes, Izama can go over here and heal Hana. Okay, like that. And just get him with some experience. Now, let's go here. Anyone else could use healing? Nope, everyone else is fine. Let's move up here. Here. Just moving everyone around. And then Sakura up here as well. Okay. What's happening now? Okay. They're in range. A lot of us are in range, so I think I'll have Sakura. Well, do I want Sakura to do it? Yeah, I'll have Sakura activate the Dragon Vein. Alright, so we can move in a little further. Okay. I would go on an archer off this guy when, because Setsuna is... because she's actually pretty low-leveled, relatively speaking. Okay, move up. Jump here. Okay, where can Azura reach? Because she can give another turn if need be. Let's move up here. Okay, so... these are both green, so this situation wouldn't end well for them. Okay, so just trying to get through. Okay, so she's pretty strong, but it's not enough to KO. Okay, how it's going here to attack. Go. Not the best. Okay. Trying to think things through. Okay, so. Okay, how far can they move? We're a little bit more in range there. Okay. Sorry, this is taking a while. I'm just trying to think things through because I don't know. Because I'm trying to get used to not having paired up units. Okay, so. Now, be a good idea to have. Okay, is it gonna Felicia if you go here?
So, you've made it this far. You must be Chief Fuga. Please, allow me to explain.
No.
No, you must earn the right to explain. Show me that you fight with honor.
Okay. Fair enough. Okay. No, okay. It's not helping either. Okay, so. I guess I'll go with this. Even this might end horribly.
What should we do?
Let's go with this.
Okay.
Okay, so Orochi took a bit of damage. Hopefully it'll be fine. Alright. Guess can Saizo run in and finish him off? Yes, Saizo can. I'll clean in Saizo. Okay. Well done there.
Naturally.
Alright. Means that Saizo gets a bit of experience as well. And if Tsubaki were to fly in, how would this go? Okay, that would not go well at all. Would not go well at all. Hmm. Okay, and she can't even reach there. Okay, so. Just thinking about my options. You know, because she'll probably move around here. Okay, so we can maybe try dealing with that Shrine Maiden. Okay, so we've got a red healer, and this Fuga's a mix, but he's not going to move from that spot. Okay, so we would go here. Okay, I'll just go for this. Let's go for this. See how this goes.
Got your back.
All right, okay, he dodged as well. Oh, and got the crit. All right, he's not enough to kill probably. Yeah, not quite enough to kill, but at least that means when he, with the counter attack, it should be able to kill. Definitely should be able to kill there. Okay, now, yes, it's Suna move up as well. Now, let's move up here. Up here. And up there. Give Rinka another turn, might as well Azura, just so Azura can get some experience.
Thanks.
Beautiful. Okay, and Azura got a level up. Doing good so far.
Oh.
Okay, I'm like getting used to the idea of just not using the pair up mechanic. Because yes, someone of course pointed out the fact that someone did ask, would I let's play Echoes? Well, Shadows of Valencia when it came out, it's like I'm not opposed to it, but it's like, I'm kind of like, this is a very long game and it's actually multiple games in one, so should I really be worrying about that stuff now kind of thing? Because I think, let's just say I probably won't do a Let's Play of Shadows of Valencia, because I just don't think it's a good idea personally. You know, the thing is, because I've just gone straight Fire Emblem games for a while now, so you see how this goes. Okay, just thinking about going in, sending in Kaze, sending in myself, because as everyone says, I should get support, so. Okay, go for this. This should be fine. Okay.
I'm here for you.
Okay, dodge me. I'm taken down.
It's over.
Even though I haven't used my Dragonstone at all, maybe I should consider using my Dragonstone. I'm just not sure.
This is my chance.
I'm not sure about the usefulness of my Dragonstone presently. Okay, got an Iron Club. That's good. Okay, so now what? There's always a question, now what? Now, who should take them out? Okay, so yeah, they should kill. Just go for this. Saizo and me. This should go well. Alright.
I could have done that.
Worked out well there. Okay. Now I guess. Can Hinoka just take out? Yep, just go for this, Hinoka. Okay. And take it down.
Good.
All good. Now. I've just got a diviner. We've got two diviners and Fuga himself. So I'll probably just go ahead and move Setsuna there. He's gonna run up and have Sakura heal Orochi. Because it's the only way that Sakura can get experience. It's like, can anyone else use healing? Because no, they can't, but I'll Silas run up, Hana run up. Zama, can he heal anyone? Nope, no one to heal. Jura can run up. Just give Silas another turn, might as well. Alright.
I won't forget this.
Just means that Jura can get some experience as well. Now, Silas can be up here. We all just all gather around and be ready to go. And all good to go. Gonna attack me. I should be just fine. Okay, bit of damage. It's not too big of a problem. Now, who should take him out? I'd say Saizo should take him out. How did this go? We'd kind of work from that range, but we could also go for the pair up attack, and I think that would work out better. Let's go for the pair up attack.
I'm with you.
Okay.
This is my chance.
All right. Take him down.
Stealing my kill.
Alright. Now we can go for some healing around here. So, give me the heal. That'll work out fine.
Got
can always count on you.
Oof, okay. Now, got one diviner left. Okay. Now, move around here. Now, I guess, like, who do I want to engage? I guess Silas can go here. Now, I guess Sibaki can move around as well. He's decent enough resistance. Now, up here. Give Azura, give Hana another move. So, Sibaki and Hana can be right there. Alright. Now, here. Yeah, because I want to engage it a little bit. I'm just the kind of idea that I like to initiate with them a little bit at a time. Just so I can be as safe as possible. Maybe a little slow, but it's just how I prefer to do things. Okay. We're still nice and gathered up here. Look at this merry band of people. We're all a nice, good team. That's the important thing. Go for Silas. Alright. Okay, not too much damage. It's fine, I can live with that much damage. Now I guess, guess maybe I'll move Hana here and have Sibaki go for this. Let's go for this, two of them together. Let's go for this. Oh, and of course, Hana, you miss. Hana, I'm not liking your vibe. I'm not liking what you've been... I've not been liking what you've been bringing to the table since you joined the party. If this was Conquest, I might follow people's advice and just ditch you, but this isn't Conquest, so maybe I should just keep things going this way. Okay, Sakura, run up and heal. Okay. It's fine. And Sakura got a level up. Alright. It'll level 8. Alright. Okay, so he has the katana equipped, which means he's a blue in technicality here. So, like, yeah, this wouldn't go well. This fight might take a while, that's the thing. Okay, and I guess, like, if I do the pair-up shenanigans, like they're saying, like people have been saying that I should do, and it should work out fine. And if Kaze were to go here, this would... And that would also get the... Get, like, the effect, the weakness effect. That would also weaken him. So I guess I'll go for this right now. Go for this. You've shown some fortitude. Now show me that you're worthy of my attention. Okay, Kaze, get this off. That'll just weaken him a little bit. And get the debuff down. Okay, yeah, that lowered his defense. Now... Yes, theoretically... How could this go? So... Orochi could go here. And deal a little bit more damage. That could work. I'm gonna trust that this will hit. I'm gonna have faith that this will hit. Why did I trust myself? Why did I trust myself? Why do I trust anything? Why do I believe in anything? What's the point of belief in everything if that's just gonna happen? Because it's like, yeah, blah, 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 makes me feel like a dumb. Guess I'll move Saizo up here. And Azura can give Saizo another turn. So we're fine, so then Saizo can get a debuff on him as well. So we can all gang up on him. Okay, I thought he would be able to get there. But apparently he can't. So... Okay, I was thinking that was how it was going to go, but apparently not. This might not end well. Okay, so get off a bit of damage and get the debuffs going. So I guess I'll go for this. Should be fine. Okay.
Watch out!
Oh, come on, seriously? Are you absolutely serious right now? Ugh. I'm like feeling like almost triggered right now. Just like, what the hell is going on? Yes, how did Hinoka go? Yeah, this just, like, isn't looking good in the slightest. And the thing is just, like, oh my god. And you get all debuffs from it. Like, how is he getting debuffs? Okay, after combat, reduce enemy strength by 6. Okay, that's good. That's a good. That's very much a good. Okay, so let's go for this. One heal cut. Okay, please land your hits.
I won't allow.
Okay, and you missed as well. Okay. Good little bit of damage. Okay, now we get our stat losses in order. Now people move up here. Now I'd say who needs it more? I'd say Saizo needs the healing more, so I'll heal up Saizo. Probably. Okay. Good heal up with Felicia. Now over here. Setsuna over here. And then okay, and not really in range to heal anyone else, but let's see how horribly this goes. Oh, okay.
Here I am.
Okay, Orochi, you're fine.
Let me try.
Okay. Okay. It's fine. Everything is fine. Everything is fine. Nothing horrible happened. You might as well use that to heal up Orochi. Just to get her health back. Okay. Now, is Setsuna enough to kill? Yeah, Setsuna theoretically does if Setsuna can actually land a hit. Okay, I'm gonna trust Setsuna. Even though I probably shouldn't. Come on, Setsuna, come on. Okay, about to attack first. Okay, good. There you go, Setsuna.
Quite impressive.
Alright, Setsuna. I knew you'd come through for me, girl. I had total faith in you. Even though you're the weakest member of the team. Yay. Alright. Worked out fine. Yeah, that worked out fine. It's all good.
Bah, well done. I suppose I shouldn't have underestimated one who carries the sacred Yato blade. Now I will gladly hear an explanation for the unprovoked attack on my people.
Yes.
Yes, of course. Wait, what do you know of my blade? King Sumeragi and I were good friends. I learned much about the history of that weapon from him. I also shared concern for his future, which is why it was necessary for me to test you.
Huh?
Test me? How so?
You are correct.
Speed, the blade you possess has the power to link the Seal of Flames. In the wrong hands, it could leash enough power to end the world. That is why I wanted to see for myself if you were indeed the right person to handle it.
Understood.
I see. And what are the villagers we wounded?
Listen well.
I don't know that you and your associates were acting in good faith. For what reason would Hoshiden royalty attack a stranger, and then allow his party to be peacefully captured by the stranger's tribe? No, I was well aware that something was amiss.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for believing in us. This is the first good news we've had in some time, I'm afraid.
Well, then.
No? Please, I would gladly hear your full story. But let us freshen up from the battle and sit down to a proper meal first.
Oh.
I appreciate the invitation, and believe me, a bit of rest and a meal are what we need. But we're in search of Lord Ryoma and Lord Takumi. We haven't a moment to spare.
Huh.
I see. Then you must be on your way. Best of luck.
Okay. We made a friend, that's the important thing. Oh, suppose that worked out better than it could have.
Truly.
Yes, I'm glad to know that we can still count the Wind Tribe among our friends.
Hey.
I'm still puzzling about a bit over what Fuga said about my blade. Do you know anything about the Seal of Flames?
I don't know.
No, but I find it curious they described linking the seal. Could there be more than one Seal of Flames? If so, could there be more than one sacred blade out there? It is a troubling idea. What if our enemies already possess a similar weapon?
Right,
that is a troubling thought. But let's focus on the problems in front of us before we invent new ones.
Oh.
You're right, Speed. I suppose I'm getting carried away.
Yeah.
Perhaps I've spoken too soon. Here comes Chief Fuga, and he appears to be in a hurry.
Wait.
Speed, wait a moment. How can we help you, Chief? Is everything okay?
Yes,
thank you. It occurred to me that we might be able to make a mutually beneficial arrangement. You're in need of all the men and women you can get. And we have a skilled diviner who could use some real-world experience. His name is Hiato, and he would like to offer his services to your party.
Good day.
I'm not a child.
I got that look.
Man.
Don't think I didn't.
Please, don't judge him by his youthful appearance. Hiato has mastered a number of unique skills that make him invaluable.
Hm.
I don't mean to sound conceited, but you'll be lucky to have me on your team.
Thank you.
Very well. I certainly won't turn down your assistance at a time like this.
Fantastic.
Splendid. I hope he makes a valuable addition to your team. As for you, Hayato, I'm glad to finally be able to offer you this chance to travel.
Huh?
Travel? I hope you both realize that this isn't exactly a vacation.
Mm-hmm.
Of
course. It's said that Hayato has not had much opportunity to leave the village. In addition to helping you, he'll be exploring the world for the first time. I see. I think I understand exactly how he feels. After all, I spent most of my childhood locked in a Norian castle. Huh. Well, then I'm sure you two will have a lot to talk about. And I trust you'll take good care of our Hayato. Chief, must I remind you again that I am no longer a child? You're right, you're right. And I must admit that I still feel a bit protective at times. Dad! I mean, Chief! Lord Speed, he's not my dad. He's just looked after me since I was a child.
Understood.
It's okay, I understand. Anyway, we should get going. Welcome aboard, Hayato. And thank you for everything, Chief Fuga.
You are correct.
You need to thank me. Please feel free to come back here anytime you'd like. I'm proud to have met the one whom the sacred Yato chose. We shall meet again.
Okay. So far, so good. It's good. And, I'll go for this one just in case. And, yeah, I think I like the idea of not pairing up. It worked out well for me there. Okay, so things are going on here. But most importantly, I think we'll do support conversations if we can before this ends. Okay, I got one between me and Kaze and one between me and Ajura. Okay, let's start with me and Kaze. Kaze, I have a request. I'd like to follow you around for a while.
You know I don't mind your company, but may I ask why? Have I done something amiss?
What? No, nothing like that. I thought it would be a good way to point out all the charming things about you.
Why would you want to do that?
I've been worried about you, ever since you told me you weren't a good person. It sounded like something has really been bothering you, and I want to help. I want you to see all the good in you.
That's... So, what do you say? I thank you for your concern, but I'm fine, really. Now if you'll excuse me.
Kaze, hang on! And he's gone. But I bet he's still close by. I'm not giving up so easily. Kaze! Kaze! Where are you? Kaze! Come on, don't just leave me out here. Kaze!
Lord Speed?
There you are. Ha! And you can hide from me.
I prefer if you didn't scream like that. What if there were enemies nearby? Never give away your position when isolated from the main body of the army. Please, for all our sakes, try to refrain from such behavior in the future.
Oh, yes, you're right. I'm sorry. I just wanted to find you so badly. Thank you for coming back. I know you did it because you're worried for my safety.
Which just goes to show you how good of a guy you are. Why do you insist on saying such things?
Huh?
Please stop. Just leave me alone.
Kaze!
My apologies, my lord. I should not have spoken to you so rudely.
No, this is all my fault. I've been pestering you too much. I'm sorry, Kaze.
Lord Speed!
Aww. I just want to be like a good guy. I want to help him out. That's the important thing. Alright, one between me and Ajura.
Hello, Speed. What brings you here?
I decided to take a little stroll. The breeze feels so heavenly.
Yes. All that sunshine filtering through the leaves reminds me of Hoshido.
Haha, I envy you. In Noir, we didn't have days filled with sunshine.
Oh, Speed, how stupid of me.
Huh?
That was thoughtless of me. I never should have brought that up. It should have been you and Hoshido all those years, basking in the sunlight.
There's no need to feel bad. It's not like you kidnapped me and took me to Noir.
I know, but I still feel guilty. I lived with the royal family and received all the love that should have been yours.
Please, Azure, you shouldn't worry. My life hasn't been as hard as you think.
But I lived in Noir. I know what that was like. It's a cruel place to grow up.
That's true. Noir can be a harsh place. But I have happy memories there, too.
Really?
Of course. I was just remembering this one time. Oh, no. I'm late for a meeting. I'm sorry. We'll have to continue this later.
Yes, I'd like that.
Getting to know Azura. We both were children who were kidnapped at a young age. Okay. So, Tsubaki has two supports. One with Roshi and one with Hana. So, I think I'll start with one with Roshi first.
Tsubaki, I've been looking everywhere for you.
Sorry, Orochi, what can I do for you?
It's what I can do for you, my happy-go-lucky friend. Though you wouldn't be so happy or so lucky for much longer.
What? Have you seen my future?
Yes, never have I seen a bleaker one. Soon you'll experience one unfortunate event after another. The odd thing is that these events will be minor, though many.
Minor misfortunes? Then I'll surely be able to weather them.
How wrong you are. There will be too many, too often. You'll get a splinter in your finger, a spider will drop on your head, food will spatter your white clothes, you'll chip your tooth on a peach pit. Any one of these would be forgettable. One after another, madness.
I agree, especially for someone like me. My perfection, shattered.
Exactly, Tsubaki. And that is why I rushed to find you. I know the key to survival. You must stop being such a perfectionist, accept life's little messes.
Certainly not. Well, I'll make sure none of those things happen.
Oh? How?
I'll stay on guard around the clock for these problems. I need to only be extra vigilant. Easily done.
I'm sure if anyone could survive a maelstrom of minor mishaps, it's you. Good luck, Tsubaki.
Okay. Although she seems a little weird, I'll admit that. She seems like she has other intentions. Just at all times, she has other intentions. But whatever. Let's have Tsubaki and Hana. Tsubaki and Hana.
How much today is today's all about horseback riding?
Yep, it is.
What's the matter, Hana? You don't look too motivated. Don't tell me you want to surrender without even taking the field.
No, that's not the case.
I mean, I would definitely understand if you did. When it comes to horseback riding, I'm the superior contender here. Are you ready to begin, then? That tree at the top of the hill is the goal. Whoever gets there first is the winner.
Got it.
All right, then. Ready, set, go! Ha! Ha!
Okay, they're riding their horses up.
Haha, I win. Looks like we're back to square one.
Look, how could you beat me?
My secret is not having fallen off my horse when we first met.
No matter what I did, my horse couldn't seem to catch up to yours. Did you have some elaborate plan put together in order to beat me?
I didn't have any strategy. You know that I'm the last person to plan ahead in most situations.
But I got the sense today that you were calmer than usual. That was the strange composure that you had. Was that your secret?
I guess I just wasn't concerned about whether I could win or lose. In the end, we were battling over who was the best of Lady Sakura's retainers. We thought that would be proven in tests of skills, right?
Yes, I guess so.
But when it comes to serving Lady Sakura, it's more important that we are both able to protect her, not who can do it better. This realization took a lot of the frustration I was feeling right out of me.
So that's why you were acting so calm. Horses can sense the demeanor of the rider, and they react to that. I was so wound up in focusing on winning, and my anxious energy was bothering my horse. But your horse must have felt the calm rolling off of you, and thus synergized better. You deserve this win.
So, it's a draw then? Should we keep competing like this?
No, we have no reason to keep competing. Just like you said, the most important thing is for us is to protect Lady Sakura. It's right that we push ourselves to be better, but we don't need a winner.
I agree. I'm sorry, Tsubaki. We got into this fight because I was so rude. I shouldn't have injured your pride.
No, I earned some of the blame as well.
You're a kind person, Tsubaki. I might yet forget you fell off your horse the first time we met.
Somehow I doubt you'll ever forget that.
Well, I won't tell anyone at least. Let's be good friends from now on and keep defending Lady Sakura.
Okay, Hana.
Ah, they're good friends. One other thing. They've patched up and they've become better friends. So, I guess next episode, we'll go off and do Chapter 9. Hopefully continue our search for Takumi and Ryoma, and hopefully and potentially reunite myself with my brothers. See you guys then.